All right. Legislation at the heart of the president's recovery plan advancing now in Congress, it looks like, despite some opposition from the Republican side of the aisle. And we get back to Doug Flynn at Flynn Zito Capital Management to talk stimulus this morning. Is it coming down the way you think that you'd like here? I mean, it's a lot of money, and it is split to some degree between tax cuts and spending, not maybe as much in tax cuts as we originally thought. What do you think?
Yeah, the tax cuts, it's sort of a mixed question, because whether somebody's going to get $500, some people argue that, you know, what is that really going to do?
And what does it do? I mean, when you talk to people about how they're going to invest their money or how they're planning for the future and whatnot, just a little short jolt like that, a few hundred bucks, I mean, doesn't help people that much, does it? Or does it in some income levels?
It does. This is the thing. Certain people, it will not make a difference for, but there are people that absolutely are struggling. And we were doing a radio show and had a call in, and the person said that $500 makes the difference in them, you know, being able to just get very basic needs. So, you know, there are instances where it does make a difference.
So is that a quicker way to help people that are struggling in the economy, as opposed to spending money longer term on things that, you know, might need to be done in the country but won't give that instant boost like more money in your pocket would?
You know, it's how they want to, where they want to put the money. I don't think that those are great long-term solutions, but that isn't sort of what seems to be the plan right now with that piece of the stimulus package.
Meaning that you'd rather see them not be spending money and just on long-term things like infrastructure and other things like that?
You know, the markets will do what they do, and we'll get through this, and it's tough to work through it, but most people haven't really planned accordingly. They didn't have a savings built up as a backdrop. They really do live paycheck to paycheck. So for a lot of people, it makes a big difference.
That's what you're finding. When you have clients come in and you ask them about, you know, what they're thinking about for the future, are you finding that they just weren't ready for this?
I think even if you were planning for it, we have a saying in the office. We were sort of prepared for a Category 3 hurricane, and we got a Category 5.
It just got slammed by.
Yeah, so you could have done some planning, and still you would have been blindsided.
So what do people like that do now? Do they rely on the stimulus from the government, whether it's in the form of tax cuts or some other thing, how do they get themselves out of it? How do you dig yourself out of a hole that seems like it's, you know, you're looking straight up and it doesn't seem like you can see the top of it?
I think it's a valiant effort to try to help people, but the problem is they're also looking at tapping their 401k, they're stopping contributing to their 401k.
Which usually isn't a good idea on either front.
Again, these are all short-term Band-Aid things that in the long run could really make it worse if they have to do it. But, you know, it's not going to solve your problem. You can't wait for a check from the government and hope that that's going to solve all your problems.
All right, Doug. Thanks a lot. We appreciate it. We'll be following that story out of Washington. But in the meantime, poor earnings, global economic slump, that has been putting pressure on several of the world's biggest currencies, none more so than the British pound sterling, which has been taking a pounding. I know that's been an overused phrase here the last couple of days, but it's true. And Ashley's going to come back here from the UK in a moment to talk about his currency and what's going to be done about it, especially after that GDP figure this morning, which was brutal. Speaking of brutal, look at the futures. They're down 2% plus ahead of the open this morning, and we're on top of that. GE earnings in the next hour. A lot coming up on Fox Business Morning. We'll be right back.